Honorable the Prime Minister of India, Shri Narendra Modi ji, our chief guest, Honorable Donald Ramotar, the President of Guyana, our guest of honor, Honorable Madam Mashabane, the Foreign Minister of South Africa, our special guest, Honorable Shaukat Ali Sudan, the Vice Prime Minister of Mauritius, Honorable Governor of Gujarat, Shri Om Prakash Ji Kohli, Honorable Chief Minister of Gujarat, Shrimati Anandi Ben Patel, Honorable Minister of IT and Communications, Shri Ravi Shankar Prasad, Honorable Minister of State for Finance, Shri Jayant Sinha, Honorable Minister of State, Independent Charge, Program Implementation and Statistics, and Minister of State in my own ministry, General V.K. Singh. Last but not the least, our Secretary, Ministry of Overseas Indian Affairs, Shri Sunil Soni. Distinguished delegates, members of the diplomatic corps, and my very dear friends from Indian diaspora. Let me at the outset extend a very warm welcome to you all to this Pravasi Bharatiya Divas. Friends, it is apt that this year PBD is being held in Gujarat, marking the 100th anniversary of the return of Mahatma Gandhi to India from South Africa. Bapuji gave shape and character to India's freedom struggle. He demonstrated the power of non-violence by precipitating the disintegration of the mightiest empire in the world at that time. He also fought against indentureship and the exploitation of Indians around the globe. It is a fitting tribute to Bapu that we have with us today Honorable Donald Ramotar, President of Guyana, as the chief guest. Our warm and friendly relations are embedded in historical, cultural, and traditional links. We have just commissioned Excellency, well-known sculptor and Padma Shri awardee Biman Das to build a monument dedicated to the arrival of Indian indentured laborers in Guyana. Excellency, we look forward to taking our relationship to greater heights for the mutual benefit of our peoples. Friends, it's a particular pleasure for me to welcome our guest of honor, Honorable Madam Mashabane. She is looking so good and gorgeous in Indian attire. She's wearing a sari. Excellency, your presence here today underscores the value you attach to our common legacy and cooperation in the struggle for freedom from colonialism and oppression. I'm happy to note that South Africa is a partner country at the vibrant Gujarat summit being held in Gandhinagar from 11th to 13th January 2015. We are pleased to have with us Vice Prime Minister of Mauritius, Honorable Mr. Shaukat Ali Sudan. Friends, the historical and civilizational connection of Mauritius with India is so deep that they take pride in calling their country Chota Bharat. The PIOs in Mauritius celebrate the arrival of Indian indentured laborers as Apravasi Divas, which I had the privilege of attending 2 months ago. Gandhiji visited Mauritius in 1901, and as a tribute to him, the National Day of Mauritius is celebrated on March 12th, which is the date of launch of the Dandi Salt Satyagraha. Owing to the strong diaspora ties and the great pride in our shared ancestral heritage, Mauritius has been an active participant in the Pravasi Bharatiya Divas since its inception in 2003. I respectfully welcome the Honorable Prime Minister, Shri Narendra Modi, without whose guidance and leadership this event would not have been possible at this scale. I welcome Governor of Gujarat, Shri Kohli ji, for gracing this occasion. I welcome Shrimati Anandi Ben, Chief Minister of Gujarat. Friends, Gujarat happens to be the partner state of PBD this year. I welcome my colleague Shri Ravi Shankar Prasad for helping us release the stamp on this occasion. I also welcome Shri Jayant Sinha, another colleague of mine in the Ministry of Finance, for helping us release the commemorative coin on this occasion. Last but not the least, I welcome my own Minister of State, General V.K. Singh, who supervised personally all the arrangements of this PBD, and Sri Sunil Soni, who executed our decisions with great speed and efficiency. Friends, the term diaspora in ancient Greek refers to a scattering or sowing of seeds. The presence of Indians abroad can be attested to from the days of remote antiquity. Our classical texts describe the long journeys that saints and monks undertook for the spread of knowledge, peace, and love. This was followed by several waves of outward migration over centuries, from the medieval period to the colonial, and then the post-independence era, resulting in diverse communities of people of Indian origin in various parts of the world. The present-day travel of Indians as professionals, laborers, traders, and entrepreneurs to the rest of the world is a continuing saga of Indian migration. Our common bond, however, continues to be the mother tree, India. The Indian diaspora today constitutes an important and in some respects unique force in world culture. In the past couple of decades, it has grown into an energetic and confident community of over 25 million that has given India a presence in almost all parts of the world. However, it is not a one-way interaction that benefits only one side. It pleases all Indians when the overseas Indian community is respected for its work culture, discipline, successful integration with the local community, and for its outstanding contributions in their countries of residence. A successful, prosperous, and politically influential diaspora is an asset to India, much as a strong and self-reliant India would be a source of strength and inspiration for the diaspora. This synergy acts as a vibrant bridge between us and sustains our relationship. The Government of India is determined to work closely with the diaspora to leverage each other's strengths to mutual benefit. The Prime Minister himself has taken the lead in reaching out to the overseas Indian community and engaging them. We welcome entrepreneurs, investors, and professionals from the diaspora to partake in our endeavor to develop the motherland and restore it to its past glory. I promise you that it will be a mutually rewarding and satisfying partnership. I believe you have the unique insights, perspectives, and the extensive natural links that can make this partnership work. I again welcome the delegates who have joined us from far corners of the globe. I hope that deliberations in the next 2 days will generate new ideas to address issues of concern to you and help enhance the quality of your engagement with India. The doors of my ministry are always open to you all. We would welcome your new ideas and suggestions on how we can work closely together. With these words, I again welcome you all. Thank you.